The eruption that created Lake Taupo is the world's most recent super eruption and is one of the largest eruptions in the history of New Zealand. It was so unbelievably powerful to the extent that it undoubtedly affected the entire planet's climate and poisoned vast swathes of land. It completely transformed the North Island's landscape, topography, and habitability status. And the caldera that was left over was partially filled with water, creating the stunning Lake Taupo, which draws many tourists to its waters in the present day. In this video, we'll be taking a look at the gigantic Oruanui supervolcanic eruption and breaking down what happened both during and after it occurred. This is part two of the series on New Zealand's Taupo volcanic zone. In episode one, I covered the most recent eruption that occurred at Taupo at some point between 180 and 233 AD. In this episode, the Oruanui supervolcanic eruption takes us back 26,500 years ago to a period of time when the Earth was glaciated and still stuck in an ice age. If you like this content and want to see more, consider subscribing and clicking the like button, as either of these really help the channel out and allow videos such as this to rank higher in YouTube's algorithm. The largest and most destructive volcanic eruptions have a volcanic explosivity index of 8, meaning they, at a minimum, release 1,000 cubic kilometers worth of material during the eruption. This is a freakishly large amount of ejecta to come from a single eruption, and it can literally turn a serene landscape into a vision of hellfire within a split second upon occurring. The 1,000 plus cubic kilometers that were released during this eruption are made up of the following deposits. There are roughly 430 cubic kilometers of pyroclastic fall deposits, 320 cubic kilometers of pyroclastic density current deposits, which are mostly ignimbrite, and 420 cubic kilometers of primary intracaldera material, equivalent to 530 cubic kilometers of magma. This brings us to a total of 1,170 cubic kilometers all up released during the eruption that now exist as deposits. The eruption itself has been divided into 10 distinct phases, based on there being 9 differing layers of tephra, with a 10th that is poorly preserved. When the eruption came to a halt, several hundred square kilometers of the surrounding land had collapsed into the empty magma chamber to form the caldera that hosts modern-day Lake Taupo. In present day, beneath Lake Taupo, lies evidence of a structural collapse, similar to the one we discussed during episode 1, which triggered another huge outburst flood, which I'll discuss shortly. The outline of Lake Taupo itself partly reflects volcano tectonic collapse, and because the eruption occurred through a lake system that sat above it, many of its deposits contain volcanic ash aggregates. The Oruanui eruption showed many differing and somewhat unusual features, ranging from there being an episodic nature to them, to there being a wide range of magma-water interactions that had occurred. But perhaps the most unusual would be the complex interplay of pyroclastic fall and flow deposits. Much of the North Island was blanketed in toxic layers of tephra, with enormous quantities of ignimbrite deposited over much of central North Island. In some places, it is deposited in layers up to 200 meters deep. Most of New Zealand was affected by vast quantities of ashfall, with layers as thick as 18 centimeters deposited on the Chatham Islands, 1,000 kilometers away. Volcanic ash is extremely hazardous in various forms, from the inhalation of it causing a slow, prolonged end to any living organism that does so chronically, to it poisoning any water supplies it enters. Another occurrence following this eruption would have been acid rains, which, unsurprisingly, wreak havoc on plant and animal life. Similar to the most recent eruption was the occurrence of a dam burst roughly 22,500 years ago. Lake Taupo at that time filled to about 75 meters above the present-day level until the water had finally cut its way through the Oruanui ignimbrite dam that was holding it in place. The result of this was the release of about 60 cubic kilometers of water. The flood was so powerful it hurled 10-meter-large boulders as far down the Waikato River as Mangakino. Throughout time, erosion and sedimentation from this eruption have had a strong, long-lasting effect on the land, and may have caused the Waikato River to shift from the Hauraki Plains to its current course through the Waikato to the Tasman Sea. It's not difficult to get an idea of just how disastrous the situation would be if an eruption at this scale was to occur again in the present day. New Zealand would be rendered completely uninhabitable in an instant, and that includes the South Island. Australia and Indonesia would receive huge concentrations of toxic volcanic gas, and there'd be major implications on the climate of the entire planet due to a volcanic winter occurring from the release of a huge amount of aerosols. This can very quickly spiral out of control, as it has in the past, and volcanic eruptions that were 10 times weaker than Taupo led to instability among many countries, along with riots, famine, disease outbreaks, and more when they occurred. Modern humans have never experienced anything this large and are not prepared for an event like this to occur, which we can say with certainty considering the whole world was locked down and entire economies destroyed from an event that I can't help but view as minuscule when compared to a supervolcanic eruption like the Oruanui eruption. But with destruction comes beauty, so let's enjoy the beauty that exists as Lake Taupo in present day and think less of the destruction that will inevitably occur someday in the future. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed part 2 of my Taupo series. If you did, leave a like. It really helps the channel out. And if you'd like to see more content just like this, hit that subscribe button and click the bell to be notified of every new upload. Thanks again for watching. I'll see you all real soon.